The day has broken now. The day has become clear. The sky is blue, although there's still a good deal of cloud about, and the sun is streaming through. The whole sea is a glittering expanse of green with white crests everywhere. And everywhere, too, there are ships. Every kind of ship one can imagine that would be needed in an invasion. There are all our landing craft, for tanks, for infantry, for every type of supplies. There are great troop ships in great number. There are battleships, smaller warships, destroyers, patrol craft, escort ships. And in the sky overhead, there are aircraft of about half a dozen different kinds that I can see at this moment. One could not imagine a more stupendous scene. All of these ships, all taking their various parts in this invasion. The whole sea itself seems restless and excited with the tension of the moment. The sky is moving and changing the whole time in a high wind, and in this dramatic natural setting, we are moving towards the shore. The battleships and other bombardment ships over on the flank are pouring in their fire. And now, other warships moving across our path are laying a smoke screen that is taking the place of the cloud which formerly lay over the waters. A dense smoke screen over on one quarter. And now there's a signal from the flagship.
All hands to beaching station.
All hands to beaching station. That's the signal for our sailors on board this craft to get ready for the landing. This is the day and this is the hour. The sky is lightning. Lightning over the coast of Europe as we go in. The sky is lighter and the sea is brighter, but along the shore there's a dense smoke screen as the battleships and the warships, the smaller warships, sweep along there, firing all the time against the shore and some of them laying a smoke screen for us. The sun is blazing down brightly now. It's almost like an omen, the way it suddenly come out just as we were going in. The whole sky is bright, the sea is a glittering mass of silver, with all these craft of every kind moving across it, and the great battleships in the background blazing away at the shore. There go the craft past us, the other landing craft. Some are left behind, the slower ones, each taking their part and going in at the right time for their right job. Destroyers, corvettes. I can hear the sound of anti-aircraft fire. I can't see yet whether it's our people who are being attacked. There's an enormous cloud of smoke along the shore, not only from the smoke screen, but from this terrific bombardment. All the ships are blazing away now. All around this enormous circle, there are ships. Ships moving in, ships on patrol, ships circling, ships standing to and firing. We are passing close by a cruiser that has been taking part in the bombardment, but is now on, I imagine, a sort of general patrol. You can't imagine anything like this march of ships, like soldiers marching in line. I've never seen anything so expressive of intent. It's a purpose shared among many ships and among many hundreds of thousands of fighting men who are going in now to the coast of Europe to do the biggest job they've ever had to do. I can't record any more now because the time has come for me to get my kit on my back and get ready to step off on that shore. And it's a great day.